Good morning, my brothers and sisters, coming to you from the great Pacific Northwest. It's a Friday morning with a little bit of rain and rain forecast throughout the day, but that's okay. The rain that we get today will help make sunshine throughout the year in a beautiful green place that we live in. So we accept the rain, even though it's not always fun when we go through it. Our verses today come from Philippians 4, verses 4 to 7, and as they say, rejoice in the Lord always. I will say it again, rejoice. Let your gentleness be evident to all. The Lord is near. Do not be anxious about anything, but in every situation, by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, present your request to God, and the peace of God, which transcends all understanding, will guard your hearts and your mind in Christ Jesus. And when we're talking about rejoicing there, it's not about just having an outward smile. It's not about putting on a mask when things are going rough. It's about having a joy that comes through our heart, even in the midst of hardship. As we mentioned, it's going to be raining today, and it makes it a little hard for all the kids not being able to at least go outside and play in the yard. And yet, at the same time, we know that it brings about the beautiful fall or summer and fall that we're about to have that's coming up. And so we accept it, and we use it, and we rejoice that it comes. In the same way, we want to rejoice in the trials of life, not in such a way that we look forward to them or we want them or we pray for them, as much as we simply realize that when we go through these things, God can use it to bring about glory in our lives and through our lives, and that God can use it to reach out to other people. So my prayer today really is the idea that we want our life and the things we're going through to be a ministry to others, that people would see us and recognize that even as we go through difficulties, God is right there walking beside us, and we rejoice. And speaking or thinking of those going through difficulties, the ones that are on my heart today are the kids that are in foster care and kids that are in unique situations. In this time with the coronavirus, a lot of our focus is on our seniors, which it should be, and on those who are most affected by the virus. At the same time, what it's doing is it's forcing our child care workers and others to not be able to be as involved in the lives of kids as they normally are. Kids who are in tough situations, maybe struggling, maybe facing some dire things themselves and aren't getting the normal help they need. And so let's pray for them today as part of our prayer time. So let's pray together. Father God, we come before you today, and we thank you for being God. We thank you, God, that you're walking beside us and that you're with us through each hardship and each trial and each good time that we're going through, that you're always there. Father, today as we come before you, we specifically want to lift up the children in our community, those who may be in harm's way, those who may be alone, those who may simply not be able to get their needs met in the way they're accustomed to right now. Father, would you bless them today? Would you walk beside them and be with them and just help them through their struggle? At the same time, Lord, would you open up their challenges, their needs to the people around them? And help us, Lord, to reach out and to love them as best we can, even in the midst of social distancing. We also pray, Lord, for the workers, the child protective workers, the CASA workers, those who are advocates for these kids, and pray, Lord, that they would have your wisdom in helping these kids and knowing how to help them. Pray for the teachers that are out there trying to teach online and to reach out and minister to their kids through the internet. Father, we thank you for the technology we have that allows these things to happen. But Lord, bless with your wisdom that we may truly be able to help kids today. Father, again, we always want to pray for those who are hurting. Bless their needs and their bodies, and heal those that have needs according to your will. Father, thank you for all that you're about to do in our lives today. And Father, we pray that you would help us to take these verses in, that we might truly rejoice in our spirits, even if we're struggling through a hardship. Father, may we rejoice in who you are. And Father, for all these things, we ask them in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, and we trust you and thank you in advance for all that you're about to do. In Jesus' name, amen. Well, there you have it. I hope this helps you to rejoice a little more today and to be thinking and praying for those kids that may have needs in your circle of influence. And until next time, I just remember that you are much loved and appreciated. God bless.